Hello, good morning, everyone. This is Heather Gonio at Versium, and I'm the Senior Marketing Manager here. And we're very, very glad to have you guys join us today for our webinar, Overcoming the Silent Killer of Marketing ROI with Versium's APIs. Today, I am joined by Joshua Altman, our SVP of Sales and Strategic Partnerships, and he's going to walk you through everything you need to know about our APIs and the Versium Developer Portal. All right, so just a few things before we get started. Everyone here is in listen-only mode, so we technically shouldn't be able to hear you, but just to be safe, in your go-to webinar control panel, just make sure that you're muted. And if you have joined us by phone, you can give us the ability to mute you during the webinar, just in case we need to, by entering your audio PIN. Also, if you would like to ask questions throughout the webinar, you can totally do so using the GoToWebinar panel. As you can see here on my screen, there's a little section there called questions. You can expand that and ask your questions there. And you can do that anytime, starting now throughout the webinar, and then we will hold for answering those questions towards the end. Also, we've uploaded a few handy handouts for you, which you can download at any point, starting now. They're all up there right now throughout the webinar up until we end. So we've got our Versium one sheet, our one sheet all about our APIs, which will summarize what you you hear today, and a short overview deck that also explains the value of our APIs, and the deck as well. So the deck that we are presenting today, you also have access to that as well. All right, so without further ado, I would love to introduce you to Joshua Altman, our SVP of Sales and Strategic Partnerships. Take it away, Josh.
Thanks, Heather. Good morning or good afternoon, wherever you're joining us from. I am Josh Altman. I have a pretty extensive background in helping SMBs all the way up to very large enterprises with their data needs. So today, what I would like to do is just take some time and talk to you a little bit about our brand new API developer portal. I'm actually pretty excited about the power of what it can deliver specifically to a myriad of different organizations. So without further ado, what I'd like to do is just spend some time talking a little bit about some data issues that I've encountered in my career that I hear time and time again from, like I said, very small SMBs all the way up to very large enterprises. The consistent remark that I hear time and time again is they have bad data. Their contact data within their CRM, within their marketing automation, within different solutions that they're using has erroneous, stale information. And what does that mean when you've got old stale data sitting within any of those systems that you're using internally? Well, specifically, it means that it's going to end up costing you a lot of time, which ends up costing you a lot of money, ends up costing you a lot of revenue. So how do we fix that? And that's what the APIs can help you deliver, is whether it's a tool that you're looking to utilize internally or a tool that you could potentially productize to use to enhance your current offerings to your end customers is something the API developer portal can be helpful with. The bottom line of all of this conversation that we're going to have today is that bad data is extremely expensive. And the tools that we can provide your organization with can help alleviate that particular issue. So we're going to talk about five different use cases of how you can use the API developer portal. And I'm going to kind of story tell a little bit just because I think that some of my particular instances of being in this world, I think will pertain to what we're talking about today. So use case number one, my leads aren't real. A little bit more background on me is I ran a business development team for a sales intelligence platform, a global sales intelligence platform. And I had a devoted inbound and outbound team. And what we heard time and time again was, Josh, we're getting flooded with a ton of inbound activity today. Well, is that a good problem or is that a bad problem? Well, ordinarily you'd say that's a good problem because you've got a lot of inbound activity. But are those leads real? And time again in my last position is that we would come across a lot of fake information or what looked to be real information, and it in fact was not. So how can we use the developer portal for my leads aren't real? So we just went through some of the examples of that. So the leads are just, they're missing, there is bad information, there is form fills that are not filled out. So what it ends up meaning is that you just have a bunch of wasted time. What ended up happening to my team is we just had a bunch of folks calling back or emailing back people that didn't exist. They put in bad information. So what can we do? Well, the APIs can be used to help identify and remove fake or outdated leads and obtain more current contact information. So what it does is that it effectively increases the effectiveness of your team. And it allows you to have a better understanding of your behavioral modeling of who your ideal customer is based on that inbound activity. So again, just kind of reverting back to my leads aren't real. Having duplicate or missing info or inaccurate information, again, in a CRM, on a spreadsheet, in a marketing automation tool, can lead to an exorbitant amount of revenue loss and also an extra cost. So use case number two. My email response rates are low. I'm having a ton of bounces. I'll give you another use case. In specific, I had a rep at my last company who was sending out bulk emails to the tune of about 10,000 emails to an old, outdated, stale CRM system. And I think you can probably see where I'm going to go with this particular use case. So what ended up happening was is that particular rep ended up getting a bunch of bounces that came back into his inbox. So that's not good for productivity, number one. Number two, what you should know is that about 90% of corporate email servers do not bounce emails back. So which meant that the percentage of emails that we saw bounce back were kind of in the minority. What ended up happening is that they end up in what they call a spam trap or a honeypot email. I'm sure a lot of you have heard that term before. And what happens is if you end up in those spam trap or honeypot emails too much, your company or your email domain can effectively be called blacklisted. It is a bad, bad place to be, and it is what ultimately happened to my organization. Imagine we were blacklisted as a company and my team was supporting about 50 outside sales reps. And for about 4 days, the entire organization was completely paralyzed to be able to send outside information from their corporate email accounts. We were literally following up using our personal Gmail and Hotmail accounts to customers. It's a bad, bad place for you to be. How do we avoid doing that? Well, again, what does it mean? All those things we've just talked about. So junk mail, we don't need any of that stuff. So what can we do? The APIs can be used to append your existing data to make sure that you've got valid information. It can also enrich those emails that you might have in your system, essentially telling you we have additional information, additional emails on that particular person, to ensure that you don't end up being blacklisted, so you're not getting a bunch of bounce backs, so that you are getting a better return on your investment for your marketing or sales response. So again, at the end of the day, what this does is delivers a higher email deliverability, increases the ROI, and keeps you from potentially being blacklisted. Just another really great statistic here at the bottom. Inaccurate emails cost companies and businesses a ton of money. Let's move on to use case number three. Again, another thing for me, I would walk around with a team of about 15 BDRs and they would say to me, I don't have enough prospects online, right? I only have one point of contact and I've been trying to reach that person for 2 weeks and I can't get anything done with that person because they're not answering their phone or they're not responding to their email. I don't know where my customers are, meaning I don't know if they're emailing from the United States or if they're emailing from China. So what does it mean? Well, it means that you've got a lower match rate for your online display targeting, which means that you could potentially have some missed opportunities. Okay, so what do we do about this? Well, we can use that API to essentially enrich that data like we talked about in use case number two, to enrich and append your additional contact information. And what it does, I think it's as clear as black and white, is it increases your online match rates and allows more opportunities, and allows for higher engagement with those particular prospects that you're engaging with. And again, billions of dollars are being wasted because of the fact that there's low match rates because of stale data. So the bottom line here is what we've talked about just with these three use cases. Stale data causes a ton of stagnation within a business. Number four, who are my customers? I don't know who to market to. I don't know who they are, what they do, what their lifestyle is, or any of that information. How do I get more information on my customers? How do I look at anomalies within my data so that I can be a more effective seller or a more effective marketer? So what does it mean? A lack of personalization leads to low engagement. It leads to people who you're wasting time and energy on marketing to that are ultimately not interested. Why? Because you've got stale and old data. So what can you do? Again, it all comes back to enriching the data. Instead of just having a name and a phone number or a name and address, how about having additional levels of insight, which we're going to talk about in a few minutes, to be able to segment and target the right customers to personalize your marketing and sales campaigns better. So at the end of the day, what does this do? You've got higher engagements, better response rates, and lower campaign costs. Why? Because you're working with better data. 52% of organizations say that they rely on educated guesses. I gotta tell you, that's not a good place to be, and I'm sure as a seller or a marketer or whatever capacity that you're evaluating this particular tool, it's not a good thing for you to do. That's a tremendous amount of waste. Last use case we're gonna talk about, I need to improve my B2B campaign reach. I work hand in hand with marketers day in and day out. As a matter of fact, my team works hand in hand with our marketing team. We need to improve who we're reaching out to. We don't have the right information to reach to reach those particular business contacts online. So what does it mean? Again, it means that you're going to have limited opportunities because you don't have the right information to be able to target the right folks. So what can you do? I know it sounds like I'm being repetitive here, folks, but the bottom line is if you don't enrich your data and map your business contact or your consumer contact information, you're not going to have a good reach. You're not going to have an effective campaign, or at least not as effective and as strong as it could be because of the fact that you're using old, inaccurate, outdated data. So what does it mean? It means that there's more opportunities, there's a higher ROI for marketers, and there's a higher click-through and engagements for marketers. And again, just a really great statistic here, and failure to reach those business contacts, just it elongates the sales cycle. And as a marketer or as a seller, no one wants a longer sales cycle. We want to see something happen right then and now. We want activity to happen right then and now. We're impatient people. This is going to make it so that you're more effective and can move forward in a faster capacity. So those are my five use cases. Again, Versium is a data warehouse that allows marketers to become highly data-driven by providing a higher ROI. And these are not just made up statistics, these are actual statistics that we've gleaned from several prominent customers that we've worked with over the years in their particular marketing campaigns. So let's talk about our different APIs that we have. Right now there are three at the core APIs. So there's a business API, and that'll work very well for a very small SMB all the way up to a very large enterprise, and we have use cases for all of those. We also have a consumer API, which is great for marketers to be able to enrich their information. Is it a real customer? Is it a fake customer? Using lead scoring to provide rich consumer insights. And then the final thing, which can be used for business and a consumer, is that reverse lookup. Where are these folks? Can I find out more about them by their phone, by their email, or by their address? At the core of what we do is we have over a trillion different pieces of data, both at the B2B and the B2C level, called life data. It's proprietary. We own this data that allows anybody to be able to access our APIs and really enrich information. So imagine you're staring at somebody who's wearing half a shirt. I don't really know a lot of people who wear half a shirt, but this gives you an idea of the graphic. We essentially can take a name and a phone number and really break that information down to provide it so that you are more data-driven before you or anybody else is reaching out to these folks to understand who these people are and what anomalies are within that particular data. So why does this matter? The more data you have, the more intelligent conversation you can have, the more relevant your marketing campaigns can be. I'm sure you are all starting to understand the validity of why this API can be of extreme importance for you. This is just a quick quote. I work, again, with very large to very small SMBs, but we are working with a particular system integrator. And if this sparks some interest in you, I'd be happy to discuss your use case. But we're working with a very large system integrator who has experienced phenomenal success already in being able to use our API to be able to develop a product that they are bringing to market to essentially improve the effectiveness of their current offerings. And here is just a small example of just some of the other folks that are already taking advantage and getting great results from our API developer portal. So this is what it's going to look like when you log in. Again, at the end of this webinar, you're going to receive those links so that you're able to access this. We're going to discuss this a little bit more here in a few minutes. But this will really allow you to, at the front end, be able to come in, take a look and learn a little bit more. If you found that the information that we discussed today kind of went in one ear and out the other, I get it, this is a lot of talking, but I invite you all to visit this developer portal. Again, that link will be sent out to you directly after this call. That will allow you to answer some more questions specifically about it. But once you're logged into it, you have the ability to go in and start pulling some calls yourself. And furthermore, we're offering the ability for you to go in and do this. It is free for you to register. It is free for you to go in and start making some calls on a trial basis to be able to start seeing how this can be of benefit for you. Keep in mind that there are different use cases for every single person that's on this call. I would absolutely relish the opportunity to continue that conversation with you to see how we can customize the solution to be of benefit for your particular use case. Going back to that whole thing of, you know, we talked about those five different use cases. So you remember that number one, the leads weren't real. How about using a consumer ID score, right? To know, is Barney Rubble a real person? Well, most likely he's not. But can you imagine if you had or you could use the API to be able to, you know, just go in and tell you, oh, wow, this is actually a decent lead, or is this garbage? Number two, your email responses are low and they're bouncing back. Imagine being able as a marketer to be able to have that consumer contact information, such as social media, validating their email, enriching their email if there are additional emails that can be found within our API, enriching it with a phone, making sure that their addresses are correct. That third use case, not being able to find enough prospects online, imagine being able to have all that information right at your fingertips. Again, it goes right back to number two of low emails, but the same thing. You can use that consumer contact API to enrich that to understand exactly more information at the consumer level. Who are your customers? You want to understand a little bit more about your customers. In the old days, advertising agencies used to say, we're developing a campaign for females 18 to 34. How'd you come up with that demographic? Were you using your data to understand that? Companies nowadays are not making decisions just based on their gut. It's not a good business decision. You've got to make a decision based on your data. Is your data accurate? And then understanding who your customers are. But imagine being able to log into our APIs and being able to pull out more information such as where they live, what kind of cars do they have? Are they a giving person? We have something called a giving score. We have a wealth score. What kind of sports do they play? We have all that information, enriching your data so that you are able to really take a look at it. And a deep amount of scrutiny to understand who your consumers are is really going to be the difference between success or mediocrity in your next marketing campaign. And then finally, from a B2B perspective, which is the world that I come from, how do I enrich my B2B campaign? Well, how about enriching it with LinkedIn information? How about enriching it with their business title? Imagine you as a business being able to have a much easier inbound process by eliminating so many different pieces that someone has to fill out for a form fill so that they can download a white paper from your website or so that they can unlock pieces of information from your website. No one wants to be bothered with filling in information. I know that I've walked away from many sites before because they start asking for too much information. I simply just want to leave my email, maybe my name, maybe a combination of both. But imagine being able to have the basic information, use the API to enrich that information so that when you reach out and have a conversation, you can have a more relevant conversation based on the information you're gleaning from our APIs. As I mentioned to you a few minutes ago, this is free. It's free for you to give it a try. So you've really got nothing to lose. Again, I relish everybody on this call to reach out and have a conversation with me. I'd be happy to help you discuss your specific needs and how we can be of benefit. I've heard of so many different use cases that it's kind of funny. I have to come up with, you know, something different for every single person. These APIs are tremendously helpful in so many different capacities. However, like I said, you're going to be receiving after this webinar the link so that it'll get you right over to that developer portal. You can go in there and register for free and log in and get up to 500 calls for up to 3 months. And these are just some of our self-service APIs. So if you are on the smaller end of things and you're only looking for, you know, less than 100,000 calls per month, you can do this via API self-service, so you don't need to have a lengthy conversation. It's pretty cut and dry. If you need something larger than that, let's have a conversation, and I'll include my contact information at the end of this call. So at this time, what I want to do is there's me questioning things. not the greatest picture of me, but I will say this. If you have questions, I would invite you to ask them now. Heather can go ahead and enunciate those, or if you wish, I'll provide with contact information at the end of this webinar. So without further ado, I'll kick this back over to Heather and we'll address a few questions that I think may have come up during the webinar.
Great. Thanks, Josh. We have gotten a few questions. First one, I'll take this one. Will the webinar slides be available for download after the webinar? So yes, in fact, you can download it right now if you like. Just if you expand handouts in the GoToWebinar control panel, you can download it directly from there. And then, of course, as Josh mentioned, you can always contact us at any point after the webinar. We can send it to you as well. While I'm on that point, we did have another person ask this. I can take this question too. Will we have access to the recorded webinar? So yes, absolutely. You will be receiving a recording of the webinar. Usually takes a couple hours, and you'll get that after the webinar is over. And we're also going to make this accessible too to others. So, you know, you are welcome to forward that notification that you get to a friend or a colleague, and then they can get access to it. And we'll also put it out there on our website at some point, and so anyone can just fill out their information and then be able to watch it at any point after this. All right, next question. How does this align with GDPR and data residency requirements/legislation? I'll let you take that, Josh.
Yeah, that's a great question. Marketers, sellers, it's a buzzword we've talked about for the last couple of years. It was back in 2015, 2016. GDPR is coming. GDPR is coming. Everybody wants to know about GDPR and how is it going to affect their ability to market and sell into the companies that are working with those countries that participate in GDPR. So the bottom line is that Versium is GDPR compliant. What does that mean? Well, specifically, we have data, but we have to, provide that data utilizing GDPR's code, which is a double opt-in. What that means is that we do have data, but it's not going to be as robust as it would be for other countries not participating in GDPR, obviously. But more importantly, what I should stipulate is that we are a data provider. We own our own data, but it's important to mention of how you extract the data from our APIs. Once it leaves our APIs and goes into your system, it becomes your data, which means it is your responsibility to handle it as such as you will. We can't be responsible once we do that. So at the very top of it, yes, we are GDPR compliant. If there are specific other questions about that, you can certainly ask me now, or you can also email me or schedule a call. I'd be happy to discuss that a bit further with you.
Great, thanks, Josh. All right, next question. Is Versium available as an on-premise implementation for customers who are cloud averse with this type of data?
So in particular use cases, we absolutely can. That's a conversation that we should probably have offline. Again, we do work with some customers in that particular instance. It would have to be a particular use case that would meet the criteria. But instead of elongating the question, I'm going to provide you with my contact information at the end of the call, and certainly happy to address that with you and see if we can make that work within your ecosystem.
Awesome. All right, next question. Does this apply to US only?
Our data is global. So as I mentioned, GDPR kind of throws a little bit of a wrench into things. However, our data is global. Now, as you're going to see with any other data provider, their data is the strongest in the United States. So that is the case with ours. However, we power data for companies globally. So we can certainly help you with your use case if it is, in fact, a larger footprint than just the US.
Great. Thanks, Josh. All right, last question so far. Are there docs for your APIs?
So yes, the documents, I'm gonna share them. There's a link here after we're finished here. And also you will receive some links after the webinar today so that you can go to our library and actually download those particular white papers. There is some more, if you saw on the screenshot during the actual webinar, there is, if you go to the actual homepage for the developer portal, there is some additional information provided there as well.
All right, so that is the last of our questions. Unless anyone has any more. Going once, going twice. All right, okay, keep going, Josh.
All right, thank you, Heather. So this is how we're gonna get started. Again, all this information will be sent right to you, and if for some reason it doesn't get to where you need it to be, I will certainly leave our contact information so we can have a one-to-one conversation. So we can, again, you can sign up for free at theapp.versium.com/sign-in. There's no obligation for you to go in and do so. We invite you to do it. That's how confident we are about how great this is and what a game changer this can be for your organization. Again, the API docs are available at this link. This will again be sent to you shortly after this webinar is completed. Please go there. It's a myriad of information that should provide you some additional wealth that maybe wasn't covered during the webinar today. I tried to be as thorough as possible, but I'm sure there are specific things that may have been glanced over. So again, go visit that. And if there are still additional questions, you can certainly talk to me more about that. If you want to keep chatting with me, we talked about my contact information. Again, I enjoy having as many conversations as I can as possible. This is a link for my Calendly calendar. So again, this will also be sent to you via email, but if you wanted to jot that down, if you're just chomping at the bit to get in touch with me, that is the best way to do it. Please put some time on my calendar and look forward to having an additional conversation. Finally, I'll just leave you with this. We want to be as accessible as possible. We want to engage in conversation as soon as possible. So here is our sales@versium.com. It is patrolled constantly. We will get back to you as soon as humanly possible, but we appreciate your time today on the webinar, and I hope that you found the information to be useful, and we look forward to discussing your specific use case in the near future. With that, I'll turn that back over to you, Heather, and we can kind of go from there.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Josh. Great job. I should probably tell everyone a quick story before we end today, and I just realized we should turn this into a slide as well at some point. But I have my own use case of our technology and our APIs, specifically around the business contact API. Just thought I'd share that story real quick. Of course, we run B2B campaigns all the time, here as a business. And I had run a campaign on Facebook, and my match rate there for the targets that we had was somewhere around 40%. And when I had enriched our data using our business contact API, my match rate in Facebook went up to 88%. So as you can see just from that story, this is very, very powerful stuff. And we really hope that you reach out to us to leverage the technology as well. All right. Well, with that said, thank you so much. Thanks so much for your time, Josh. Thanks for everyone for your time. Reach out if you'd like to continue the conversation. Thanks,
everyone.
Have
a great day, everybody. Take care.